This is a video for how I made my solar charger for my boat. All I really run is some accessories and lights at night off of my battery and my fish finder. And so this is the video for how I made it. So to start with, I took this Shoreline stern anchor light. I'm going to take the light off and I'm going to mount this ball head swivel. It's for a tripod and a camera. Alright, I drilled out the rivet on top of the light head. And the whole light assembly just comes right out. And that leaves me with the base that I'm after. Alright, I've taken this plumbing reamer and I've cleaned up the inside of the tube so it will hold epoxy. Next, I'm going to take these quarter inch threaded T-nuts and I'm going to file the edges down so that the T-nut fits down inside. Alright, I filed it down and now it fits down inside. I've actually done that to two of them because I'm going to weld them together. Okay, to weld these together, I put the T-nuts on a quarter inch bolt and I'm just going to tack them in a couple of places around the center. Alright, there it is. I've got it tacked in about three places around there. There's my two T-nuts welded together. I made sure they fit inside the tube. Now I'm going to mix up some golf epoxy and I'm going to glue it into place. Alright, I'm using this quick set golf epoxy. It gels in 4 to 7 minutes and it actually cures in 15 to 30 minutes. So for shafting golf clubs, this works pretty good for a fix. But for my little project, it's going to work awesome. Alright, it's had time to cure. Alright, it's had time to cure. The epoxy's set the T-nuts down inside. Now I'm going to take this swivel head mount for the camera and we're just going to screw it down inside.
She's all screwed down inside.
And this swivel mount looks like it's going to do the job pretty good. You can turn this set screw to freeze it into position. This is going to work really good when I mount the solar panel to it. Alright, this is the solar panel I'm going to be using for this project. This is a 10 watt panel. And it's roughly 9.5 by 13.5. Then I'm going to use this charge regulator for my project. And then this charge regulator has a 2-pin connector. And I've already taken a 2-pin connector and put it on the end of the solar panel. The solar panel specs are right here. This is a new power 10 watt panel. I think I picked this one up either off of eBay or Amazon. I've taken this quarter inch bolt here and I've epoxied it to a piece of 1-inch aluminum flat stock. And I'm just going to attach it to the frame with these self-tapping screws. Here you can see it all attached, screwed on. I've got my screw. I went ahead and sanded it so it's in the middle. There we can see the ball head adapter on there. All right, here's the finished product. Got the solar panel mounted to the bracket. It swivels on that ball head. Once I mount it to the boat, I can position it to the sun, tighten it down with the set screw, and trickle my battery. All right, out on the lake. Got the solar panel hooked up. It's running my fish finder. And it looks like we've got, I don't know if you can see down there, yeah, 12.9 volts coming through. Had a full charge on it when I started, and this thing's maintaining, it's actually charging quite a bit, so there you have it.